month 11 of Patreon.
Dude, quarantine special. We've got In My Time of Dying by Led Zeppelin.
You have Sunday Bloody Sunday by U2.
And then It's a Long Way to the Top if you want to rock and roll. And we do, by AC/DC.
Some great picks. Link in description. We'll catch you there. Hey guys, hope you're having a great day. It was a great life.
Dude, Rolling Stones makes its appearance again. Very exciting times.
I'm super excited, dude.
Yeah.
You said you've been wanting to share the song with me for a hot minute.
Dude, it is a phenomenal song. It's I think it's up there with like some of the greatest we've ever listened to.
How does it rank up with like the other Stones song we've heard?
I think you're going to like it better than I think pretty much any of the other ones. Maybe not than Whoa, the Children. But probably the other ones I think I like about
okay, it. Okay, fair. I'm excited, dude. I'm excited for some more Stones, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, they've been asking for it. It's time to share it.
It's time.
That being said, let's get into it.
Okay.
Right. That piano is so nice. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. The bass line.
Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for change. Killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia. I rode a tank, held a generous rank when the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. Oh yeah. I was puzzling you with the nature of my game. Oh yeah.
Love a little symbol here. Kings and queens fought for tender kings for the gods they made. I shouted out, who killed the Kennedys? When after all, it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I lay traps for troubadours who get killed before they reach. Bombay. Dude,
that fucking piano, though?
Yeah. The whole thing. So it's a very Lost in the Sauce song.
Mm-hmm.
And I also, one of the things that is crazy to me, because I actually have heard the Guns N' Roses version of this.
Yeah.
And that was the first version of this song I'd ever heard.
Okay.
And it wasn't until later that I heard this version, like the original. Yeah. And even then, I think I had only listened to like a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's so weird how they, like most bands have like this, like it's like a story that kind of ebbs and flows, has like peaks and it has like lower portions. This song kind of keeps in a pretty...
The dynamics like, pretty the same the whole time.
Which is weirdly good in this.
Yeah.
Like it's very storytelling and I don't think many songs can get away with not having a big... Like
dynamic shifts.
Yeah, big dynamic shifts. Because then it usually gets boring. We've had that criticism of other songs.
Yeah.
I thought this one was phenomenal.
Yeah, it didn't really happen here. I definitely, like, the second the vocals, like, started, I recognized the vibe, like, almost immediately. And the whole, like, pleased to meet you. Like, I've heard that before somewhere. Yeah. And it's awesome to, like, relate that back to, like, this song. No, it was awesome, dude. The little bass line, too.
Bass line was phenomenal. And keys were phenomenal. It was changing throughout
also. Yeah.
The guitar tone.
Yeah, at first I didn't like it for a second.
Wait, really?
Only because it felt so bright and like squeaky that I felt like it pierced through the mix to where it felt like seemingly independent to the rest of what was going on.
Like where it didn't lay right on the track.
It felt like it didn't like blend well. But then like as it continued, I was like, okay, I get it. Like, I feel it now. You know what I mean? It took a second.
I think it's just very different than any. I think you're right. It's very different than anything else that's going on in the track. And his voice is. Not it's kind of atypical for like a rock voice where it's a little more round, a little less like piercing, like you know, like a Roger Daughtry, Robert Plant. It's like very piercing, very like
in your face.
Yeah, and he's kind of laid back in the mix.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. I can see where that would come from.
But yeah, as it went on, though, it kind of grew on me. And no choice, and just the licks. I was digging all that sauce.
Yeah. I thought the whole vibe, the atmosphere that they built. All the percussive work, where you're not really missing a drum kit, even a slight little just like ch that they were doing like every once in a while hitting like a ride or a crash cymbal to just like tie everything together.
Yeah,
I thought was incredibly smart.
Absolutely,
and it really I like although they didn't have very many dynamic shifts by the end of it, it did feel noticeably bigger.
Yeah, I feel like maybe like a slow like rise.
Yeah, like I know they started adding a little more percussion in the left side. Again, there's like hits. The ooh ooh.
Yeah, because it ended at a higher dynamic than it started.
You don't notice you're getting there.
Yeah.
Like it sort of like sneaks up on you all the way.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like having a cat and then it's like it starts off super small kitten, and you don't notice it's growing, but it totally is.
Yeah.
No, I thought it was awesome, dude. I'm trying to think of like what to rate it. I definitely like Give Me a Shelter like I want to say substantially more, but like enough more to where that difference is noticeable to me.
Do you like it better than the other ones we've listened to so far?
I think so.
Yeah.
I'm not 100% sure. I haven't given like, I definitely like it more than like the Can't Get No Satisfaction.
Yeah.
If that's what it's called. I like it more than that one. I think I like it more than Can't You Hear Me Knocking, but I'm not sure. So I've probably only given that song a good three listens.
I think it's those longer Stone songs you need to give more listens.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But this is definitely an awesome song. Like if like, you're driving around, cruising, you play it, you're cleaning your house one of those days,
it's on the playlist. It's a good cleaning the house song. I can see that for sure. Yeah,
100%. You know? I think I'm going to give it A+ tier. I see no reason for myself to give it S tier, but I could see somebody else giving S tier, and I could like... respect that decision.
Yeah,
but I'm gonna give it A+.
I think A+ is worth that.
I don't know what would have brought it to S tier for me. I don't know.
I don't know either.
But I think it's very very strong song.
I think it's a very strong. I think A+. You've heard it definitively. A&A rated.
Yeah, I think it's a great song.
Yeah, I mean, with that being said, I guess just let us know what it's to do in the comments. Like, what more Stone song? What we should do next? And we'll catch you later.
Absolutely.